Would like to welcome you to our topic today, Future Trading with TradeStation Global Platform. And as usual, for the beginning, I want to show you the risk disclaimer that this is not an investment advice or trading recommendation. I think this is normal, as you know it all from the start. Some points for myself. I think most of you might know this already. I studied mathematics and I'm a trading coach, especially for stock and option trading, and head of TradeStation support in Germany since 2004. And yeah, what we would like to discuss today, or what are our topics today? How to use the radar screen for future trading. I think this is a very powerful tool in the TradeStation Global platform, so it's very important to know how to set it up. And also with the continuous contracts, if you want to backtest strategies or if you want to do any analysis, I think you need the continuous contracts, which are also very important to use. And yeah, the next step will be how to set up order in Matrix or other order tools. And the last thing, symbol search, which you might need for most of future symbols. If you don't know the exact symbol, it's very useful to know how to find the correct symbol for the correct future contract. These are the main points for today. If there's any question, you are always welcome to ask anything what you might need to see. And before we go direct to the TradeStation Global platform, I want to show you a few things which we got from CME, because since a few months we have micro and mini future contracts available. And this is especially for indices, which you see here, the S&P and NASDAQ and Russell 2000, as well as the Dow Jones. We also have several of Forex micro contracts, and the same for metals, means gold, silver, and palladium. And it's very important to know some basic stuff about the benefit of micro and mini contracts, especially what you can see here, since they were like registered at the stock exchange. There's a high liquidity in all the, and most of the, not in all of them, but in most of the micro e-mini contracts. Especially if you see here, for example, the E-mini S&P 500, you can see the volume on the left-hand side. See, the blue is the volume, and we have it here in millions. So it's a very high volume, means you can trade also big lots or big sizes, which will all be not a problem at all. Same or similar, let's say not same, but with oil, for example, WTI crude future, and for Forex as well. And here you can see the average daily volume for this contracts. So what I told you earlier, especially the E-mini and the NASDAQ, the micro S&P 500 and the micro NASDAQ 100 is having a very good volume for trading. For Forex, it's the Euro contract, and for metals, especially gold and oil, also have a very good volume. What you can also see in this overview, and I don't want to go through all the presentation, because we also want to see some practical stuff, how to use it in the TradeStation platform, but just for you to know some advantages comparing to ETF trading. This we should delete, because this is only for US citizens, where there's a benefit in terms of tax advantages, but it's very important that a future contract is having no management fee. In the ETF, you will always find it. Also around the clock trading, there's no not such a high risk of a gap. What is also very important is the pattern day trading rules, because for futures here, they are not applying, but for the ETFs, you will always have to follow the back pattern day trading rule. And if you see all these advantages, I would always, if there's a future contract available, recommend future trading instead of ETFs. Because as you see here in the overview, there are lots of facts which gives you good advantages to trade these micro or mini future contracts. Also, in terms of volume, what we've seen earlier, all the future contracts are much higher volume than the biggest ETF for this indice. And here, I think this is also very important for you to know. The ticker symbol itself, we will see it in the next minutes also in the TradeStation. And for us, it's important was the margin requirement. This is very low for micro contracts. That's why I think it's a big success to implement these micro contracts, because it makes it easier even for small accounts to trade these contracts. And you see, for example, what is the minimum price and how much is it in dollar amounts for the three indices. So you can really participate in future trading with small amount of money and even with small accounts. Just don't forget, margin accounts usually start with an equity of or with a balance of equivalent to 2,000 USD. And this is also the minimum to get started with future trading. We have the same overview now here for micro metals and micro forex futures, where you can see all these symbols and also what is the margin requirements. And as you can see, they are really low, what makes it really convenient for smaller accounts to trade this. So if someone wants to have more information or even want to have this presentation, just let us know. We are happy to provide this to you via email or in the next presentation. And now I want to continue with our topics for TradeStation. This is the basic TradeStation, like you should see it if you just download the application and open the TSIB, the Fold workspace, where you have indices, forex, equities, and stocks from the London Stock Exchange. Normally, I would always recommend to start with this and just change it in the way you want to have it. Means I just deleted all the symbols. I will do the following: save workspace as, and I just say TSIB future. So I will save it with a different name. So if there's any change, you should always make sure that there's a different name. And we would start with some symbols for the indices. Let's start, for example, with S&P 500, because it's the one with the biggest volume, the biggest liquidity. Just right click in radar screen, insert symbol, and then you have here this lookup function where you can search for specific symbols, and especially in future markets, and it's necessary to do, because I don't think that you might be able to put just the correct symbol for a micro or for a mini future contract. So there will be a new window where you can choose what exactly which asset class you're looking for. And as we already seen the symbols in the CME presentation, I will go for micro E mini S&P 500. And first of all, I would always include the continuous future contract. What you will see at the end with contfut. So this means it's always like an ongoing contract. What I said earlier, I think this is very important for backtesting, or if you want to see a brighter or back a greater range of data from the past. So we will do the same once again, just to get the right symbol for trading. And now we have the September contract, what also ends with a U. You just can follow the continuous contract, and then you will see it here. So, and as it is connected or linked to each other, you can see on the left-hand side the micro E mini S&P 500 in chart, and below even in matrix. The same we will do now for the Nasdaq. Actually, it's the same insert symbol. Just go to lookup, and we will do it a bit faster. First of all, continuous contract, and then the same for the September contract. So yeah, first of all, the same like with the S&P 500. On top, we have Nasdaq continuous contract, where you can see even yeah the time before, like I think before June. Because if you do the same with the September contract, the difference here is September contract normally gets only a good liquidity after the June contract expires. So that's why continuous contract, I think most of you who already trade futures, they will know this. Yeah, you need to have the continuous contract for any analysis which is going back more than a couple of days. And to make it complete, because we can also provide you this screen with all the symbols, so you don't have to type it in or to search. And that's why I want to make it complete with all the, sorry, this was with all the symbols which are available, at least for the micro future trading. Now we will continue with the E-mini Dow Jones. First of all, again, continuous contract, and then we will have here the September contract right below. And the last thing is the Russell 2000, and then we have all available symbols, at least for the micro future trading. So these are all the indices. The next what I want to include is not all the available futures for Forex, but at least the two biggest with the euro. It's the same way how we add it for the indices. So the symbol, I think it's M6A. I always do the same mistake. You have to go to lookup, and same futures. Sorry, this is the Australian dollar. And then we have, I just leave always one row empty, because if I want to add at the end of or the beginning of September the next contract for December, you can also do the same, that there's like more than one expiration date. You need to change this so that you always see exactly the expiration date, what you might need. And after we added the Australian dollar, we will go ahead with the next symbol for Forex micro future. And this is what we've seen earlier, the euro. And last but not least, we will also add at least one of the metals, and then we can continue with the chart and with matrix for order setup. So this is MGC. So now we have the basic micro futures included. And as we seen it earlier, we just can select. Let's maybe stick to the NASDAQ one. We can select the right symbol. We can also include more indicators here, seeing that NASDAQ is going down the last 5 minutes quite fast. And let's see if we can place an order. So now we sold NASDAQ micro contract, and you can see it's also very good to see the points. Every point, what we told you earlier, it's divided by 0.25 points, and this is exactly it's now listed in euro. That's what we need to change. Symbol currency, account currency. I mean, you can also leave it in the account currency. This would be not a problem, but I just want to show you this. 1 point is exactly $2. $2. I change it now to $2, and it makes it very convenient here in the matrix. And you see, it's going down more than what we expected. So if I want to just buy to cover my profit, I will just buy, and I can see now exactly my trade here in 5 minute chart. Can change it even to 1 minute, and it's very easy to use matrix or even chart trading for entry and exit. But now we want to do it a little bit more detailed, step by step, because I saw this downtrend. So I just want to get into the market with a short position. But I think now is the time to see the settings which are available for futures trading and which are quite easy to use and are very helpful for you to exit even a position which you already entered here. Yeah, for this, I will make the matrix a little bit bigger, and I want to add the advanced order bar. Then you have all the settings which are available here at matrix. As I showed you earlier, to change any columns, you just have to right click in this tool, and you will see all available available columns. If you want to see it even in your own currency, in your base currency, because it's not necessary that your base currency is also USD, if it's euro, Singapore dollar, or Swiss francs, or even British pound, you can also show your the profit and loss in your account balance. And I just want to add this as well. What is also, I think, quite interesting, it's a percentage. So now As we don't have a position, you will see no information, of course, included in the matrix. But what makes it very easy to trade in matrix is it's an automated function. What you see set up here in the order type means auto limited stop. The system will automatically decide if it's a limit or a stop order, and means if I go below the price on the buy side, it's limit. And as soon as I go a little bit above the price, it will show a stop order. Makes sense because if I want to buy above the actual price, you need to set a stop order, especially for a breakout. And if you want to buy a little bit cheaper, then of course you will set up a limit order. Now I set up my stop order. And I forgot here in the columns, as we already traded the symbol. This second thing as a column is the total profit and loss. So it will add already what I traded because we made a profit of $16, and this will be added to in this column. So but it's in euros, so we should change this one more time. So what do you want to see? Open profit loss in account currency. I'm not really, I mean, it's up to you. Me from myself, I don't want to see the total profit and loss because yeah, if you trade like the same symbol the whole day, it makes also sense to include this. But as I showed you how to change all the settings, I think it's pretty easy to change this in matrix. So now I want to set a stop order if the market's going down. It's also pretty convenient because I see the lowest price for today here at 10,505 points. I can set my stop order, and when my market is going down to a new low, a daily low, I will close my position, and I can see exactly with which loss. In this situation, it's a loss of $32 or 28 euros. It's only 0.15% of my position. And the same, what is quite interesting, you will of course see also in your chart. We come back to matrix. If I just right click in the chart, and I will show my chart trading setup. You can see here my stop order, and I can just click exactly on this stop and also change it here. What, yeah, it's very nice to have this in connection because if you want to have a fast entry in matrix, for me it's very easy to do this. And also for stop, I need a chart to see maybe what's the daily low, or if I do it on a other time frame, I can see even the last days what was the lowest and the highest price, and I can try to set this up with my with the prices there. And especially here, you can see the trend the last 30 minutes was quite strong comparing to the other days. We didn't have such a big down movement in a few minutes, but our long position is still in profit. And even when I want to close it, I just hit the close button here. And it's very nice because all the orders, my stop order, for example, was closed or was canceled, and a market order was placed so that I closed my position. And if we go back to matrix, we will see in total, you can see it here, my closed profit and loss just on this symbol today was 25 euros and 50 cents. So I think for trading, if it's especially short or intraday trading, it's very nice to use matrix and chart trading also to yeah, set up your stop and your target. And the last thing what I want to show you here in matrix, it's how to set up order cancels order position. Let's go back long. Just this time, press the buy market button. Of course, you can also still place it here with a limit order or with a stop order, what we did earlier. I think this is really nice to have and easy to use. And if you're not so sure for the beginning, you can also use it in the paper trading account, what makes it maybe a little bit more easier to practice without losing any money. And after I'm invested, I can place an OCO order, means one limit and one stop order for exit. I can set this up here in points. Okay, my limit order is this was a little bit too close to my entry. So it's very important that you change here the price offset, what was only 10 points. And yeah, luckily we got executed with a small profit. But this you need to change, but we can do it, of course, once again. So as we already have a good profit and loss, I will do it with 30 and 30, and then I can show it to you again. So this is now my stop. I can easily change this. And of course, you can also change it in chart, what we discussed earlier or what I showed you earlier. It's the same way like we do it in Matrix. Just click on the order and then press the left mouse button or keep it pressed and then just move the limit and stop order to any place in Matrix which you want to have. So I think, yeah, this is a very interesting and useful tool. Especially for short-term trading, I would always recommend or suggest to do it with this tool to configure or to change settings maybe a little bit. As you can see already, we are going now onto our profit target. And as soon as the profit target is reached, our stop order will be deleted. And you can see, especially that's also something when I want to show you the liquidity, the volume is super high. I mean, we can here enter the market even with bigger positions of 10 or of 5 or 10 contracts. And this is also a big benefit which I forgot to show you in the beginning in the CME presentation, because if you're trading with the big future contract, it's hard to get like a good entry price. If you divide it maybe with micro contracts into different entry prices, it's much easier. And even if you are future trading with a trader with a big account, it's also a good option to think about micro trading, because it gives you the opportunity to divide your position in more contracts than if you just trade the big future contract, for example. So you can get a good average price if you want to buy, if it's going down a little bit more. So there are a lot of benefits, and I think the most important is that we have volume, and this is something what's also a good and interesting thing, what you can see here in Matrix, the with the number in total. And now it was a little bit faster than what we've seen here in the matrix. Our order was again executed. Let's have a look in our intraday chart. We just go back to 1 minute. There we can see what did we do in the last minutes, and it looks like we really hit the bottom. It's not with our short order that we got all the way down, but with the last three long entries, we also had a good profit. In total, we have to check Matrix again. Just a second. Yeah, 65 euro in total profit. And now we can try it again with a short position, what we can also do here in chart trading. There's same sell and buy market button. Hit and take is just like, if you press the hit button, your sell short order will exactly be at the price of the best bid, and take is exactly the price of the best ask. So it's a limit order at the end at best bid or best ask. And if you want to have a better entry, you can also use this button on top. It's placing a sell order on the best ask, so you have to be a little bit patient. And here's a buy order on the best bid, what's of course also a limit order. Let's try to go long again. So you see our limit order was placed at the best bid, and now you have to be a little bit patient if it's going down again to get an execution. So now we are entering the market, and exactly the same what we did in Matrix, we can do here also in chart trading. So at the end, it's up to you what you prefer, but there are many ways for short-term and long-term trading, how to use both of these tools. Here we go with our stop and limit order. So you see, it's really easy, really convenient to do this in Matrix or even in chart. And it will help you not even only for future trading. Of course, you can do the same for Forex, for equities, for CFDs. Today, I just want to show you how to get the correct symbols, what's the benefit of micro contracts, and especially what is, I think, easy to see here, what we have in liquidity. Same if we go to the Dow Jones, it's not so high volume what we've seen earlier. Sorry, this was the future contract. Of course, the future contract will. Oh, this is the correct one. Should all you also give you the volume bars? But let's have a look at another section, what we will have here, Forex. You see, it's different to Nasdaq or to E-mini. It's not such a high volume, but still, if we for Forex, there's a brighter range. So it's, I know, not really today. For Euro, we can also try to set an order here. And it's at the end the same way. We just want to place an OCO order with a stop and a limit. And you can easily change it in the matrix and chart. Yeah, as you can see it here, it's not moving so fast like in future contracts, but it's working in the same way. And if you want to cancel or change an order, it's also working in the same concept like for futures. You just have to click on limit or stop order and change it there. And I think with the tool, what we see in here in radar screen, where you can easily access the right expiration date. What was the last thing what we traded was Nasdaq. Let's see how it's going. Yeah, we also are again in a small profit. So yeah. We can wait till the limit order is reached, but I can just say close and this close button here. Let me highlight it. The close button here will do the following. It will close my position, but before it will also cancel all existing orders. And especially short-term trading, what's also very nice is this reverse button because it goes one step further. It closes my long position. And then the same time places a position or a position the other way around where we are short selling. So as you can see, it's very easy to do all the setups here in Matrix, especially what we did now was very short-term invest or short-term trading. We just been here for a couple of minutes, and even if it's only micro mini futures and we just traded always one contract, you can see the result was pretty good with 78 euros, yeah, for maybe 20 minutes, which we been trading here. and to make the setups for Matrix complete, I think duration is should be pretty clear that this is a way to set up orders for more than one day, and the same is GTD, where you can set up a date. For example, if you're like not on the computer the next days and you just want to set up a stop order till you are back, you can enter an exact date of the duration or till when your order is valid. So I think the most common is day and GTC. GTD is not, I think it's not used so many times, but just for you to know. And one thing what we didn't explain yet is trailing stop. It's also something very interesting because you can set up your risk in percentage. If I said I want to risk 1%, I can set up my trailing stop here with 1% distance from the last price. You can also set up an amount. Let's see, what does it mean, 1%? We should see this here in Matrix. So then we have to scroll down a little bit more, because 1%, here we are. Yeah, it means a loss of 189 euros or $214 dollars, and it's the same. I can also click on my trailing stop and change it, and you will see as soon as my our stock is going a little bit up, you can see now the trailing stop is just running behind. Can double check, now the market's going against us. But let's see if it's going up a little bit, then this will be also something what is moving and where we will see changing in the trailing stop itself. And the last thing, I mean, OCO order, I think we discussed steps. We can also cancel here all orders for this particular symbol, what we included in Matrix. So it's not for all symbols, it's just for the symbol which you opened at the moment in your Matrix. And let's have a look if our stop already changed. Not really, it's, no. No, it's $206 dollars. But it should, as soon as we are going to profit. Or we can also easily check this in a chart, because in chart, if you use this background tracking here, you can scroll a little bit down and we see our stop order now. If you see the price, this is exactly what I mean. It's moving 1% behind your price. If the market's going against us, of course, then it will be fixed and execute our stop if it's going down till this level. But as long as it's going up, it's always running 1% behind or whatever you set up for this trading stop. And to change it, it's also the same. I can say, okay, 1% is way too far for me. I want to have it with 0.3%, for example. Just click on the trailing stop and you will easily move it up in a chart or in a matrix. So it's exactly the same what we had earlier with our OCO order. And the last thing in future trading, what's also nice, even in Forex or equities, you can use it. It's the activation rule. And activation rule, you will find an advanced order bar. So this settings is normally not there from the beginning. So you have to check view, advanced order bar. And then under activation rule, just check activation rule and hit the button with the 3 points. There you can set up a time and a price when an order will be activated. So let's see, we can, it doesn't mean that you need to connect this exactly to the symbol which you're trading, but of course it makes sense. So look up futures. we will go for our NASDAQ future contract. And now I say, okay, if it's going up to 10,600 points, I want to set up the following order. Let's cancel first the, so let's make it a little bit closer that we will see it maybe now live. Let's make it to 10,590. So now you see, oh, so it's a little bit fast. I added a sell market order, and this market order will only be activated as soon as we reach this level of 10,590 points. So it should be hopefully in 3 points if the market is playing with us. We have to be a little bit patient, but normally it looks really good that this will be executed in the next few minutes. I normally use it for entry orders because I want to say, okay, if the first 30 minutes where the market is very volatile is over, then I want to place an order on a certain level. So activation rule really helps you to do this. Now it's going down a little bit, but yeah, we can wait a little bit, or I can even change this activation rule. But don't forget, you have to set the order again, because now the order is placed with the activation rule of 10,590 points. So when we want to change it again, let's do this. Let's make it a little bit lower. Yeah, this should be a good price. So I think now, yeah, it was a bit too fast to see, but if I want to show you again, it was 10,581.75 points. And as soon as this was reached, my market order was activated. Of course, the time, which we also checked here, was the time now. This is something what we can also change to maybe just prevent that you're not trading, or this order will be not executed in some time where you don't want to trade. And even for the conditions here, you can include also, yeah, other conditions. I can also add like ETFs, stocks, which should have a certain range till I want to activate my order. And you have here this end or raw condition, what's pretty smart. And even in the Trader Workstation, you have the same settings what you can find under alerts. So even in an alert setup, you can add a order, means when these conditions are reached, you can place the order automatically, and their market or stop order, whatever you might need here. So yeah, this is the 4 points what we discussed. Radar screen, very helpful if you just want to trade more than one or two symbols, because then you can easily access them from a radar screen and have them in a chart and in the radar, the matrix itself. Continuous contract, especially for backtesting of strategies, what was like not enough time to present you this. But I think we spent a good amount of time, and we had like only profitable trades today. We made like 120 euros in this short term of NASDAQ micro future trading. Symbol search, always right click in radar screen, or even in chart it works the same. So if you said like, okay, I'm just trading for instance one symbol, then why should I use the radar screen? This is absolutely correct. And in the chart it's exactly the same. I will just show it here. You have to right click, format symbol, and then you have here this function lookup, where you can also search for future contract where you might not know the exact symbol, especially with the expiration dates. I have to say it's not so easy to find it here in TradeStation. That's why I can offer you to provide the radar screen and this workspace what we set up here. So you have the most liquid futures in micro futures here included, and you can add everything what you need to add, what is maybe missing for your trading strategy. Yeah, and if there's anything else or anything what is missing, please feel free to contact us via email, and we are happy to provide some more information in our upcoming webinars. So if you liked this short presentation for future trading, please subscribe on the right-hand side below to our YouTube channel, so you will not miss any of our next upcoming webinars. And we are happy to welcome you here again. Thanks.